لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. قال الله تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وجعل منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدى هدى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، my brothers and sisters in Islam, today we will discuss a hadith the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam relates to us, which contains three pieces of advice. And if one was to implement these advice, three pieces of advice, and understand them well, then he will surely live a happy life. These three pieces of advice will change our lives. It was said about these pieces of advice, هذا الحديث جمع الخير كله, that this hadith, it encompasses all good. Good for us to live a happy life in this world and the next. These three pieces of advice help us navigate through this life, through the waves and through the storms. This hadith will help us to do that. It was narrated by Abu Ayyub al-Ansari. جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال: يا رسول الله علمني وأوجز. حسنه الألباني. Abu Ayyub al-Ansari says a man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم seeking advice, saying to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, teach me a concise lesson. Educate me with a concise lesson. This hadith was graded sahih. This hadith was graded sound by Al-Albani. We know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not give except which is the best advice and guidance, because the best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's why we said that at the beginning of the khutbah, وخير الهدى هدى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The best of guidance is the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet replied, advising him, equipping him with the knowledge that will benefit him in this life and the Akhirah. He said عليه الصلاة والسلام: إذا قمت إلى صلاتك فصلي صلاة مودع. If you stand to pray, then pray the farewell prayer. If you stand to pray, pray the farewell prayer. Pray as if this is the last time you will pray, to never pray again. That was the first piece of advice. He then went on to say, عليه الصلاة والسلام: لا تكلم بكلام تعتذر منه. وفي رواية غدا. He said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, do not speak with words which you will apologize for. And in another narration, tomorrow, i.e., do not speak with words that tomorrow you will have to apologize for. وأجمع اليأس عما في أيدي الناس. Relinquish hope of what the people possess. Do not look at those who are above you in the dunya. Rather, be content with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. So this hadith, my brothers and sisters in Islam, revolves around three pieces of advice. The first, concerning the prayer, preserving it and praying properly likewise. The second is about the tongue and safeguarding it. And the third is about al-qana'ah, being content with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you in this life. The prayer, my brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِذَا قُمْتَ إِلَىٰ صَلَاتِكَ فَصَلِّ صَلَاتًا وَدِّعْ. Pray like someone who's saying goodbye to this life. Pray like someone who's never going to have the opportunity to pray again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the prayer, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. In Surah Al-Mu'minun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, successful indeed are the believers. And this is specific to the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here has specified the believers and only the believers. And as we know, there's a big difference between a Muslim and a mu'min, a person who has iman and a person who submits to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here, he's talking to the believers. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Indeed, the believers are successful. Which believers are we talking about? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. The believers that in salah, they have khushu'. They have full submissiveness and concentration. And this is a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the believers are successful, this does not mean just in this life, rather it means this life and the next. And we also learn from this ayah that the more you complete your iman, the happier you will be in your life. Imagine, my brothers and sisters, praying every salah that you pray during the day and night, as if it was your last prayer. Imagine with me how that will affect your life. How that will affect the happiness during your life. The Prophet ﷺ said in another hadith, مَا مِن مُسْلِمٍ يَتَوَضَّعُ فَيُسْبِغُ الْوُضُوءُ ثُمَّ يَقُومُ فِي صَلَاتِهِ فَيَعْلَمُ مَا يَقُولُ إِلَّا انْتَفَلْ وَهُوَ كَيَوْمِ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ. There is not a Muslim who performs wudu. And when we say performs wudu correctly, and then he prays, knowing exactly what he's saying, except when he departs the prayer, he's like the day that his mother gave birth to him. He's sin free, everything wiped off. Imagine that, my brothers and sisters. Imagine praying every salah, knowing that this is your last prayer, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hoping, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove and extinguish all the sins, that you have that salah. How will that affect you, my brothers and sisters? That is the prayer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about it. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Indeed, this is the salah that removes from a person immorality and evilness. We have brothers and sisters that come to us and ask, brother, I've prayed, but I still feel like doing sins. I still feel inclined to doing this sin. I still feel inclined to disobeying Allah. What's the issue? I thought in the salah to tanha anil fahsha'il munkar, I thought if I pray the salah, that's it. I'm no longer going to commit this sin. Which salah is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about here? The salah which is prayed correctly according to the conditions, pillars and obligations. The salah that is in accordance to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The salah that you start and finish and everything in between, you understood what you said. You understand why you say Allahu Akbar. You understand when you return from ruku' and say Sami'a Allahu liman hamida. This is the salah that removes the evilness and immorality from our lives. This is a hadith that is specific to us as individuals and general to us as a community. Our community and us as individuals will not prosper except after we begin to learn how to pray the salah correctly and implement that. The second advice the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام gave this man, وَلَا تَكَلَّمْ بِكَلَامٍ تَعْتَذِرُ مِنْهُ غَدًا. Do not speak, do not utter words you will apologize for tomorrow. Meaning, you will apologize if this person heard what you said about him. Or you will apologize on يوم القيامة in front of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. This prevents us from uttering statements on our tongue that will end up coming to bite us tomorrow. And if we was all to implement this piece of advice, لَرَأَيْنَا فِيهَا خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا, we would see so much goodness in our lives. If you utter something that is forbidden, and we know there are different levels of evil of the tongue, different levels of statements that a tongue can utter that is evil, and the worst being uttering statements of shirk, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, uttering statements of kufr, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, and after that, statements of bid'ah and innovation, and after that, the major sins, such as backbiting and slandering. Before you speak, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you this tongue. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you control over what you say. And therefore you will be held accountable yawm al-qiyamah for what you have said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you this control and ability to hold your tongue comes with something else. Comes with accountability. So now we all know that once we say something, we'll be held accountable for that on Yawm al-Qiyamah. So think, my brothers and sisters, about what you say. This life, we spend it trying to gather all the good deeds we can from sadaqah, from zakah, from salah, from siyam, from qiyam, from having good akhlaq with your neighbor, from showing good relations with your colleagues at work and at school. We got this whole life, that's our only purpose, to gather these good deeds and stay away from the sins. So imagine Yawm al-Qiyamah coming in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala having a mountain of good deeds. A mountain. And only a little bit of sins. You think this is the perfect situation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy upon you, remove these sins from you and enter you into Jannah. However, what happens to the person who backbited, slandered, and spoke about others behind their back? What happens to this person? He begins giving out his good deeds. And he begins taking the sins of those he spoke about behind their back. Until it comes to a point where the good deeds have decreased and the sins have increased. And now this person has become bankrupt. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from bankruptcy in this dunya and the akhirah. Amen. Do not waste these deeds, my brothers and sisters, and nullify them through the evil that comes out of your mouth. You may end up giving them your good deeds and taking their bad. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين وله الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. وبعد, the last piece of advice that the Prophet ﷺ gave us in this specific hadith, he said عليه الصلاة والسلام, وأجمع اليأس عما في أيدي الناس. وأجمع اليأس عما في أيدي الناس. Relinquish hope of what the people possess. Do not look up to those who have more than you in this dunya, hoping to have what they have. Be content with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. Brothers, remember these piece of advices are not given by a man like me and you. They're not given by a wise man. Rather, they're given by the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The best of creation, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about him, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not speak out of desire. He does not speak from desire. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. Everything he says and does was wahi, was revelation. From who? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that reason, this is why we take his piece of advice to the best ability that we can. Do not take it with a grain of salt. This is the hadith and the speech of the Prophet ﷺ. which is technically revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah forbade us from looking at those who are above us in the dunya and wanting what they have. He ordered us to be content with what He has given us in this dunya. Even if that is little, being thankful for what you have from little may be a reason for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase you in the dunya and akhirah. He says, عز وجل إن شكرتم لأزيدنكم. If you thank me and show gratitude, I will increase you. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not given you much in this world, then know, when you worship Him the way that He deserves to be worshipped, عز وجل, then your rizq and your provision in the akhirah will be far greater. And if Allah has given you which is plentiful from this dunya, then give for the sake of Allah. And thank Him also. Show the gratitude so that He may increase you in the dunya and akhirah. وَرْضَ بِمَا قَسَمَ اللَّهُ لَكْ تَكُنْ أَغْنَى النَّاسِ. Be pleased with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. You'll be from the richest of people, regardless of what you have. Does that mean we sit back and relax? And we say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me little, so I'm accepting little. I'm not going out to work. I'm not going to study. I'm happy with what Allah has given me. Of course not. Of course, that's not the position the Muslim should take. Rather, he goes out and sees his provision. He does what he can from himself. And whatever he gains, in return, he is thankful for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him. He's content. And remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلَ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever places their trust in Allah, Allah is sufficient for them. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل. اللهم اهدي شبابنا، اللهم اهديهم، اللهم اهديهم، اللهم حبب إليهم الإيمان وزينه في قلوبهم، وكره إليهم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك، يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك، وصرف قلوبنا على طاعتك، ودخلنا جنتك. وصل اللهم وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أقم الصلاة.